Hi, welcome to Chris BI. Today we're going to be talking about how you can become a data analyst in 2020 for free. Stay tuned. I'm going to go into it. All right, so we're all on a break. We're all working from home, and we want to improve our skill sets. We're hearing tons of stuff about data and analytics as being the wave of the future. You want to know how you can get started expanding your career, doing more with data in a reasonable way with the tools and resources that you have at hand while you're working at home. I'm going to show you right now a ton of tools and resources to get you started right away. All right, let's get on it. Boom. All right, again, we're off at the Microsoft Learn site. Links in down below. Oh, and before we go too far, if you like the content that's coming out, you want to learn more about data, technology, and analytics, how to make it part of your life, like, subscribe, hit that little bell icon. We'll continue to turn out these hits and, you know, help you guys learn how to work inside of these new data frameworks that are out there. So Microsoft Learn site, great resource, highly recommend starting out there. They have a ton of learning paths that are available for you. I'm gonna recommend, if you click on Browse All, you're gonna find over 1,200 programs that are available at the time of this viewing. They're constantly putting out new content. If you're looking to be a data analyst, I've kind of gone through a bunch of these classes, and the easiest way to find the ones that you're looking for is if you drop down on the role set section and choose both, and this is really important, choose both business analyst and data analyst if you want to really get all of the classes that are going to be relevant to you. All right, you just do data analyst, you're going to miss a number of different classes that are available that might be relevant, and if you just do business analyst, same thing is true for you. So make sure you select both of those when you're looking for classes out on the Microsoft Learn site. All right, I'm going to talk about my top few that you should look at doing first, and then I'm going to show you some other resources that are available as well. So the first one I always talk about anytime we're talking about people working out in Azure, working out inside the cloud, is Azure Fundamentals. This is going to cover a lot of the basics, a lot of the building blocks of working in the cloud, and how that's going to be different from working on-premise or working on just your laptop. This will really help you out as you're getting started working in this new landscape. Highly recommend it. First and foremost, get started with the Learning Path program for create and use analytics reports in Power BI. This has a ton of different classes in here. It's over 6 hours long. If you go through and make sure you learn everything that goes on inside here, I highly recommend both this class and this Azure Fundamentals. Run through these potentially a couple times. You know, the first time you run through it, breeze through, go through at a high level overview, and then run through with a much more fine-tooth comb, trying each of the examples, working with them, working with it within your specific needs and your specific use cases. Really dig into these two. There's a ton of high value right off the bat to get you started there. All right. The next class that's really important for you is this Configuring a Business Central in Excel and Power BI. The big thing to remember here is that Excel and Power BI are all part of one ecosystem, right? They all work really, really well together. Power BI, all of the tooling that's in Power BI was first available and still available inside of Excel. Especially when well, not all, but like the big blocks, right? Power Query, Power Pivot, those are all of the engines that really drive the Power BI environment, right? And it's actually what the great part of it is. Power Query and Power Pivot are the same engines that are being used to build out all of Azure. And the analytics platform out in Azure. So if you learn and work in Excel, you're going to be able to take those exact same skills and abilities and translate that into Power BI and out into, you know, out into the Azure service. Those skills and abilities will intermix. So tons of value inside of here. Get started with doing that. And the next thing, that this is kind of like a bonus, but understanding how you can use Power Apps, Power Automate, to help drive the interaction between your Power BI reports or Excel is going to add a ton of value to you and your business users. This is Power Apps and Power Automate is a low-code, no-code environment that allows you to go in and build out your own content. All right, those are the Microsoft Learn tools and resources that are available, but there's more. There's tons more out there, and it's all for free. Now, I'm going to look at out on KratosBI.com. I've got the home of the data gods. I featured different data gods and content that's out there that you should be aware of. Two big guys, in fact, these are the old gods of business intelligence and data. That would be none other than Marco Russo and Alberto Ferrari. These guys have literally written the book on everything when it comes to Power BI and analytics inside of the Microsoft space. Really do check that out. Highly recommend also going out to their website. This is where they have a number of new training courses that are available to you. We've got their out on SQL BI under their training section. They've got their introduction to DAX and introduction to data modeling. Again, the links to these classes are below. I highly recommend going out and spending some time using these. These are free classes. You can go out and use them. They both, you know, Marco and Alberto do have paid training programs that are totally worth it. There's a price that goes with it, but there's also a, you know, the price is significant, but there's a significant value that's there too. So if your training budget's at work, these are the guys that can really help you. But this introduction to Power BI and this introduction to data modeling that Marco Russo has right here is incredible. You should really check these guys out. Totally worth your time and energy, super high value. Now, next guy I'm going to introduce, I'm going to talk about, as you can see, I even got their shirt on, Discover EI. These are some our good friends from down under, Alice and Christian. We're going to go over to Christian. Christian and Alice are the founders of Discover AI. Alice just got her MVP. Way to go, Alice. Christian is working on his. I'm sure he's going to get his MVP at any moment. Both of them have an incredible blog series that's out on their website. Again, links below. Highly recommend checking them out for improving your analytics and improving your data story telling. I'm going to hone in on one specific one that I'm a big fan of that I haven't talked about before. And this is how you can incorporate images into your Power BI reports. This really helps in telling a clear, concise story so that when users go into your Power BI content, it's immediately apparent what it is they're looking at and what this information means. So take the time, go out, check them out. They are, the content that they have is out of this world. Really check that out. All right, thank you guys very much. That was how you can become a data analyst for free in 2020. If you like the content, hit like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification so you know when you have more content that's coming out. If you want to support the channel even more, go out to KratosBI.com and I will buy me a coffee and I will send you, as part of my thank you program, I send out these I Love Power BI stickers as long as I have them. Those will go out to you guys. Thank you guys for all your work. We also are just introducing a new merchandising site. So if you love the data gods and the data gods that we're putting out there, check out the merch site. I even have one. We've got data god merch available. You can go out and get your own data god t-shirts. We got data god stickers. So if you want to get any of your various data gods and goddesses that are out there, go out to my merch site. Again, link below. And as all of the proceeds, everything you do that buys is money that goes right back into this channel. So we add in new lighting. We've enhanced our camera. We're building out new streaming capabilities. I'm working on building out an Azure resources so I can do more training and demos for you. But thank you very much, and we'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.